everybody, welcome back to another video, and I'm introducing my dad.
Hey everybody, yeah, so if you clicked on this channel, the title is How I Reached 500 Subscribers as a 10-year-old YouTube Gamer. So we're basically going to talk about the experience that we've had with Tyler as a YouTube gamer over the last 10 months. You know, recently we reached the 500 subscriber mark on the Trickus YouTube channel, and we have a goal to try and get monetized in the next year or two. So as we're talking through this, Tyler's just going to be playing some, it looks like Call of Duty right now, but he's going to provide some commentary as well as I kind of go through some of my thoughts on this.
Yep.
So, you know, really in some ways, reaching our 500 subscriber goal was easy.
Mm-hmm.
And in other ways, it was pretty challenging. So today we're going to talk about what has been easy, what's been hard, and really tips on for new YouTube gamers or for those that are thinking about starting a YouTube gaming channel. You know, we've got 10 months under our belt, which isn't much, but we've definitely learned a lot in that time. So we're going to provide some tips on how to get more YouTube subscribers.
Yep.
And we'll especially discuss the debate on whether new YouTube channels should be should create both long form and shorts content, because there's quite a bit of debate out there on whether new YouTube channels should do that, and with whether it cannibalizes the long form content with the shorts. So, Tyler, let's start talking about what was easier than we thought. First of all, I think getting started.
Yeah.
Getting started was super easy.
It was super easy.
Now, we started out super cheap. We ended up buying a $30 capture card on Amazon and started recording with OBS, which is Open Broadcaster Software. So that's a streaming, it streams the gaming content directly to a laptop. And then we also had an old microphone that we used for our audio. So getting started is easy. And really the biggest challenge for that is just to get started, just to do it, right?
So,
and we'll talk about that a little bit more here. You know, and then for video editing, we used the free software VSDC, which is for PC. And so making the videos, editing the videos, was a little bit hard at first, but you pick it up as you go, right? It gets easier and easier as you go. And there's a lot of content that you can reuse over and over again. I would say coming up with ideas for videos.
Yeah. Like, you gotta think it through.
Right.
Then, like, before posting it, like, would it be a good idea or a bad idea?
Exactly. And, you know, we have different ideas that we bounce off each other.
Yeah.
And so I think, you know, it's nice to have somebody to talk to discuss ideas like, hey, you know, would somebody like to watch this, you think, or not? So if you know, we're a father and son team. But, you know, if you have a friend or a family member, a brother or sister, bounce those ideas off them. Just want to mention, we kind of got rid of our $30 cheap capture card setup. It wasn't the best. It got us started, but it wasn't the best. We had a lot of problems with the video didn't turn out that like we had thought it would be. So we ended up getting, we bought the AverMedia Live Gamer Portable 2 Plus.
Yep.
Not a sponsor. so we got that for fairly cheap, used on Amazon. And that really makes the capturing the video game content so much easier than it ever was before. Has a built-in microphone head jack, so you can hook up a microphone and just, it records directly to a micro SD card. You know, but speaking of audio, that still is a bit of a challenge with this AverMedia capture card. The problem is that the video game audio and the audio that we record into the microphone are on the same channel, essentially. So you can't split audio and video. So we were struggling with the video game audio being too loud and you guys not being able to hear us. So there's actually a couple of videos that we still have posted that aren't that great. But again, but that just takes time.
Yeah, but hey, like, you get like a couple extra views, and I mean, yeah, it's all worth it.
It's all about the views, yeah, especially early on. Your first videos, Mr. Beast talks about this a lot. Your first 100 videos are going to be terrible.
Yeah.
Right? And so the key is to, number one, get started. Just make the videos. And then number two, just make sure that every other video that you create is slightly better than the last one, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So as you learn, as you go through this process, you'll get better and better at it, and your content will reflect that that experience. Another thing that I think was fairly easy, although we're still kind of going through the process a little bit with us, is thumbnail creation.
Yeah.
So creating thumbnails, you got to create really eye-catching thumbnails that people are going to first look at with, you know, on whether you're looking on a phone or whether you're looking on a computer. You got to capture people's attention.
Yeah.
So they click on the video. That's one of the hardest things. But we use an online tool called Canva that has some really great YouTube thumbnail templates that we can adjust and edit and things like that. So that's something I would highly recommend. Now, we do pay for the Canva license. I think it's not that expensive if you pay for an annual fee, but you really do get a lot more tools when you actually pay for that tool. And then I would say, you know, since we hit 500 subscribers, I don't know, I think it was a week ago, I think getting the subscribers is fairly easy to do.
Mm-hmm. Especially on shorts.
Exactly. And that's the thing, is that shorts come in handy when you want to build your subscriber base. Mm-hmm. Now, the watch time that shorts delivers to you when people watch it, I mean, some of our videos, we've got 10, 12, 13,000 views, and that's hundreds of hours of watch time for a 15-second video. But that time doesn't count towards your monetization launch hours. Uh-huh. So we view shorts as more of a way to build our subscriber base. So that's how I would think about that. And we'll talk about shorts here in a little bit more. So what was more difficult, Tyler?
Difficult. Well,
than we had anticipated, right?
Yeah, I think.
I would say the time commitment.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right? So it does take time to have a YouTube channel, to build a YouTube channel. I would say, as a tip, you know, we started out creating 4 to 5 long form and shorts per week. Yeah. We were really cranking the material out there. Number one, because we didn't have any content, you know, to work from, so we needed to build our portfolio of content out there. But then number two, it helped us to really quickly learn how to make videos and to get better at it, right? So over the last, I would say, 2 months, we've really tapered back. And so now we're doing maybe one long form video per week and one short form video per week. And that seems to be kind of the sweet spot for us right now.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Especially when it comes to the YouTube algorithm. And that's another thing that I think is difficult, is that just trying to figure out what the heck the YouTube algorithm is thinking. There's a lot of times that we'll create a video, we'll spend a ton of time making the video, doing all the editing, and you think it's going to be a fantastic video that people want to watch. But then you post it and you get 10 views, 12 views, and it's like, man, I put all that effort into it and nobody watched it. And it's really kind of frustrating at times.
Yeah.
But then there will be other times where we'll throw up a video that took us, I don't know, 20 minutes to record and another 30 minutes to edit. And it gets hundreds, maybe thousands of views.
Yeah.
Right? So that's one of those things where you really just don't know what the algorithm is thinking.
Mm-hmm.
Now, one of the things that we have noticed, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, Tyler, but the modern games, like this Call of Duty that we're playing now, we get a lot of views right up front,
mm-hmm.
like the first 2-3 days that we post the video. But after that point, it really tapers off. Now, we also do a lot of retro gaming videos as well, because we have a fairly extensive collection of retro consoles, retro video games, yeah, things like that. When we create those retro gaming content videos, they're slow to start, but they have a long, what's called a long tail. So people will watch these videos 2 months, 3 months, 6 months, a year down the road, mm-hmm, compared to the modern ones where it's, you get a short burst and then that's it. And I think that has a lot to do with the YouTube algorithm trying to figure out who our audience is, right? Whether it's our audience is for modern gaming or our audience is for the retro style gaming. So it takes some time for the algorithm to figure out, hey, yeah, you know, Joe Smith in Arkansas, he's a retro gamer, so let's feed him this retro gaming video from Trictus. Yeah. Right? So it takes a lot of time, especially as a new YouTube video channel where we're not on the first page,
yeah,
of when you log into YouTube. What else we want to talk about? So I guess maybe let's start talking about some tips for you guys.
Yeah.
As either brand new YouTubers, maybe you've had a channel for a month or two, and that's more gaming focused, or perhaps there's gamers that want to get into creating a YouTube channel around the topic of gaming.
Yeah.
So number one, just start. Like I said, Mr. Beast says that just focus on making each video better. The first videos that you create, honestly, nobody's gonna watch, right? So don't feel embarrassed, don't feel bad that you're putting out a video that's not as good as one of the other YouTube gamers that you like. Just start creating the content and get better and better and better. Number two, I would say, don't choose a gaming topic that's too narrow right away. Yeah. So for example, there's a lot of YouTube channels that only focus on a single game, right? Yeah. They're very good at the game, they focus on it. But eventually trends are gonna change. And you know, that YouTube video and your audience is going to disappear perhaps overnight. So that's why we've kind of, we have a very broad channel.
Yeah.
Where we do a lot of these modern games for we've got Xbox, we've got PlayStation, we've got the Nintendo.
Yeah.
All the modern stuff, right? But then we also have all the retro stuff.
Yeah, all the retro stuff. That's...
So we've got all, you know, going back to the Atari days, the original Nintendo, Super Nintendo, Genesis, all that stuff. So we can tap into not only the modern crowd, but also the retro crowd as well. And that gives us a chance to build up our audience a little bit faster than perhaps we... would otherwise do. Now, I would say one of the negatives to that is that I think the YouTube algorithm sometimes gets confused yeah, about who our audience is, and so sometimes it won't push our content to people that perhaps might be interested in it. Number three, I would say try and find something about your gaming channel that's unique or that other people can't necessarily duplicate easily. And again, this goes back to our gaming collection. We have a pretty sizable gaming collection that we've built up over the last several years. And a lot of people don't have access to this type of stuff. So that's why we, especially in our shorts, we use a lot of our retro gaming content and push that out. And that's how we get a lot of our subscribers. I would say another thing is think about gaming from a trends perspective and riding those trends. There's been a couple of videos, Tyler, where there's perhaps a new game coming out.
A new game, yes.
Where we'll review a demo.
Yeah, like, a game demo. What was that game called? The one...
Prince of Persia.
No, not that one. The one on our live stream. What was that one?
I don't remember.
I think it was something about space. Starfield.
Oh, yeah, when Starfield first came out.
Like, we thought that one would be, like, exploded, we spent like a 30 something dollars. I can't remember.
Yeah, we got the early access for that.
And then we didn't expect it to, well, we didn't.
Well, we thought it would blow up, but it didn't. Yeah. So, you know, we took a gamble on Starfield and, mm-hmm. and that didn't work out. But there was other ones, like we did a demo of Prince of Persia that got multiple hundred views and some subscribers from that. And then also like Call of Duty, if a new update comes out or a new season comes out or there's a new Easter egg that people are interested in, you've got to ride those trends. And so there's been a couple of times with Call of Duty, for example, that we've done a couple of Easter egg videos that have gotten thousands of views.
And like let's say Black Ops 6, like it's coming out.
Exactly.
Like, kind of like tomorrow, I don't know.
Yeah, and the Xbox announcement and all that stuff. So we might do a video tomorrow on that.
Yeah.
To just kind of talk about our reaction to what Xbox is planning to do, not just from a Call of Duty standpoint, but for all Xbox games. So ride those trends. And another example is that was very successful for us is in the October season, we started playing spooky video games, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So, you know, Halloween season, people are interested in, you know, trying to scare themselves and get into the Halloween spirit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So we played Luigi's Mansion from start to finish, recorded the whole thing, and that was one of our most successful video series we've ever done.
It exploded! Man, I was so surprised. Like, that level, I can't remember which video.
Yep.
I mean, I guess people were really stuck on that one.
Yeah. So for number five, I would say, don't focus on monetization mm-hmm. as a YouTuber, especially when you're starting out. Now, this is a trap that we fell into. We thought that we were going to start our channel, build up our 1,000 subscribers, get our 4,000 watch hours, and we'd be off to the races. The video game segment on YouTube is very, very saturated right now, and it's really takes a lot to start building up an audience.
Yeah.
So that's why, you know, think of it as, you're building up your audience, you're preparing yourself to get to that monetization point, but more so having fun, right? We always have a good time making these videos.
Yeah.
So that's what you should focus on, is just really enjoying yourself, at least starting out. You're not going to make enough money where this is going to be your full-time job at this point. So.
Yeah.
Tyler, you're lucky you're 10 years old, so you're starting very early. So number six, I would say, don't listen to those people that tell you to not create YouTube Shorts.
Yeah, don't.
Again, YouTube Shorts has been by far the easiest way for us to get subscribers. Because, again, most of the long-form videos that you put out early on, nobody's going to watch them, right? So how do you get people's attention? Well, YouTube Shorts.
Yeah.
So I would say 100% create YouTube Shorts. We've done it. We've been very successful at it. That's how I would say 70% of our subscribers we have come from YouTube Shorts. So number seven, I would say, take advantage of tools like YouTube Studio.
Studio.
YouTube Studio. And then there's another one that's called vidIQ.
Yeah. So YouTube Studio is so accurate on your views and subscribers than YouTube when you look at your...
Yeah, it gives you much more accurate results. It gives you statistics and analytics that you can use to learn from. So you can figure out things like, well, what is the age of my audience?
Yeah.
Where do the majority of them live geographically?
Or what is their gender?
Right, gender. You know, do they live in the United States? Do they live in the UK? That's the majority of people that watch our channel is those two countries. So you can, you know, and then based on that information, you can better tailor your next videos to cater to those people. VidIQ is another great resource. Again, we actually have a free version of it. We're not paying for it right now, and they're obviously not a sponsor. But they help you you can put a VidIQ plugin into your computer, and when you upload your videos to YouTube, they'll give you really good suggestions on title names.
Title names. Thumbnails.
Some thumbnails. Yeah, some keyword searches, tags. They'll give you suggestions on what tags to use. And really, basically, they'll kind of walk you through what you need to have when you create that video on YouTube to give it the most bang for the buck.
Yeah.
And then, you know, number eight, and this is the final one, and just make sure that when you're creating this YouTube gaming channel, think of it as an investment of your time. So right now, Tyler's not making any money today. We've been doing this for 10 months.
Yep.
But what he's doing, he's creating a foundation for the future. So by the time he's 15, 16, 17, 18 years old, and if he keeps at it, this channel might be making a decent amount of money. We might be able to figure out how to get this thing to explode. And then at the end of the day, if by the time he's 18, if YouTube no longer exists and there's something bigger and better out there, at least he's learned a lot about content creation, about gaming, and really about marketing. So with that, Tyler, you have anything else to say before we end this?
I just have to say that if you want to become YouTube gamer, you just got to put faith into it. Like, let the universe tell you to, like, make one. If you don't want to, if you're, like, trying to make a gaming YouTube channel and you just don't want to, you're just backing up, let the universe have faith into you.
Yeah, that's great.
So
we'd like to hear, you know, if you guys have any comments or questions for us, feel free to put them below. Please feel free to subscribe as well. We'd love to have you on board with this journey.
Oh, yep.
And otherwise, take it away, Tyler.
Yep. See you next time. We might make a Black Ops, 6 YouTube video. And subscribe and like, and see you tomorrow.